The National Security Review Council, which keeps tabs on the progress of strengthening national security, convened for the first time last evening at the Presidential Secretariat. Religious leaders including Mahasangha, the Speaker, the Prime Minister, senior parliamentarians, governors, representatives of political parties, including leaders, vice-chancellors of state universities, the Defence Secretary, Chief of Tri-Forces and other security forces participated in this council.
The Parliament, media and the public suggested that the scope of National Security Council be widened to include more views on national security given the situation of the country. The heads of security forces and intelligence units have informed us that the security of the country has turned better. Your ideas are very important in strengthening national security. We hope to convene this council once a month. I believe that we should look at this issue giving prominence to the country and the real issue without involving politics. We got the opportunity to speak to a number of ambassadors and high commissioners on the situation of the country recently. All of them are satisfied with the country's security. China, India and United Kingdom comprise of half the number of tourists who visit Sri Lanka. I think the tourism industry can be revived if travel restrictions imposed by those countries can be lifted. It is evident that the government has failed to monitor social media or to guide it in the right direction. It is social media which infuriate people and make them take wrong decisions. It is important to search mosques. However, most importantly, we should investigate how these terrorists were funded. Although there are various legal alleys to take action on such issues like the Money Laundering Act, none of them are enforced. Therefore, we should investigate as to how money circulates in this country.
I must concede, and we must all acknowledge, that the security forces and the police have done their very best after the attacks occurred in such a manner as to give people in this country a great deal of confidence. But I don't think we can lose our guard as long as these questions remain unanswered. We have not yet been able to come to a conclusion in regard to what really happened. All that we can do to ensure that we do not make any further mistakes is to be sure that security is maintained at the highest level at all times in all places. Secondly, that we unite the people of our country, the Sinhalese, the Tamils, the Muslims, the Burghers, everyone, of whatever religion, and we come together as a united people and stand together as a united people.